Christmas time, we speak more about food and drink, isn't it? And all kinds of food. But the Lord is speaking about another strange kind of food and drink today. Normally, when you eat something, and you drink something, for what? For your life. Food will give you energy. Water will give you life to live this life. The Lord is saying today, I will give you the bread of anguish and water of distress. You know, imagine, this is anguish. You eat it. And this is distress. You drink it. You know, it means what I ate, what I drank became part of my life, part of the system. I mean, the Lord is saying it's going to be your life and it will give you strength. The harder the journey, stronger you become. And it's a formation, my dear friends. It's a clear formation. That's where Isaiah speaks about to the people, all those who are in exile. The Lord is saying, after the formation, you will come to the promised land. Of course, in that land, the Lord is saying, I will weep no more, you will weep no more. And you cry, when you cry, He will listen. He will give you, He has given you anguish of water and distress of the food. But then the Lord is saying, I'll be near you to teach you. So it's the pain will teach. The pain is the best teacher. What pain can teach you, no one else can do, my dear friends. So exactly that's what's going to happen. What we are going through now, exactly the same exile with Corona, lockdown situation. And also in our spiritual life, how many chains, fetters that chain us, block us, addictions. And we have become so captive and slaves in our own desires. The Lord is saying, I'm going to teach you. With pain, I'm going to direct you. And then the promised land, He will then give rain for the seed you sow and make the harvest abundant from the crops you grow. The Lord is saying, there will be a time of promise. And then the Lord is healing all the people. And then He says, when He saw the crowds, He was moved with pity, for they were harassed and helpless, like sheep without shepherd. Shepherding, there has to be the stick and the rod. Shepherding does not mean allowing you to do whatever you want. No. Shepherd will control you, teach you, punish you. When you are in control, Lord will teach you. How to, the rod and the staff is the distress and the anguish, the pain that you are going through. So you are in direction because He teaches you to be sent. The Lord is saying, I will send you. You will go to the lost sheep of Israel. So they are made the shepherds with the anguish and distress, with the pain. After the pain, they were formed. And the Lord will do the same in your life. And the Lord is saying, harvest is more. Let you pray that Lord will send more people, more workers to gather the harvest. Those workers should not cuddle the harvest. You know, soft pedal? No. You know, they have to take the sickle, word of God, and cut the harvest from the ground and give the ownership to the owner. That needs formation, that need strength, that need focus. We need people like that. And you and I are called to be a shepherd who harvests the harvest, who give the ownership to the Lord. For that, He will teach you. Advent is a time of preparation. He will prepare you with pain and agony. He will teach you, He will be closer to you. But then there will be a day of promise where you have the inner direction. You have that innate power within you to journey in the right path, to do the right thing. And you will have power over demons. You will have power over sicknesses. You will live with authority of Jesus. What a promise that He is giving you. That day, you will weep no more. When you cry, He will listen. After the formation, you will get the degree. You will get the promotion. After the formation, there will be a promotion waiting for you. Think about it. Have a nice day. May God bless you.